intervals, we are again meeting together. We all are busy for conducting exam, and also after that we had autumn break also. Okay, and this is the first class after autumn break, after reopening school. I hope that you all have done very well in exam, and also you have enjoyed the holidays very well. Okay, now today in my first class I'll be introducing a new chapter, that is factorizations. So before I start explaining what is factorizations, I'll suggest you to follow my small video, so which will explain you what is factorization and what are the different areas, the subtopic of factorization we need to cover. Okay, let's see the video.
Topics to be covered in this lesson are introduction, factorization, method of common factors, method of regrouping terms, factorization using identities, factors of the form x plus a into x plus b, division of algebraic expressions, monomial divided by monomial, polynomial divided by monomial, polynomial divided by polynomial. So what is factorization? A very simple term which means finding factors. Now by now all of you know what is a factor. It is a number which is an exact division of a particular number. For example, if you take the number 6, so which are the numbers which are exact divisors of 6? That means which are those numbers which can divide 6 completely so that such that the remainder is 0. For example, 1. So if you divide 6 by 1, what do you get? You get 6. There is no remainder. Similarly, 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3. So there is no remainder again. Similarly, 6 divided by 3 is 2 again. So no remainder. So 1, 2, 3, 6, these are the numbers which are exact divisors of 6. Therefore, these are factors of 6.
Then you have understood what is factorizations and how do we perform factorizations of algebraic expressions. So how to take common of the common factors from the terms of the algebraic expression. These are the different areas, then regrouping, identities, and last one is the middle term factorizations, that is x plus a into x plus b. This is a fourth identity, but actually it is used in middle term factorizations. And division of polynomial by polynomial, it will come later on. Okay, so before that, you have already come to know what is factorizations, so I am not going to discuss again. Okay, so now I am starting the textbook questions, how to perform factorizations depend on basis on the what explanations given in their video. Okay, exercise is 14.1. Okay, question number 1, part 1. What is this? 12x and 36. So factorizations means what? We have to break down the number into product of prime factors and on the also the literal factors. Okay, we have to break down, and then when you factorize the two expressions or group of expressions, then we take common of like fractions. So how can I write down this one? 12x can be written 2 into 2, 4 into 3, 12 into x. Okay, now after that, what can we write down? 36? 36 can be written 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 3, 12, 12 into 3, 36. Now question is that we have to, as per instructions it is given, find the common factors. Therefore, common factors are what? What is common here? 2, 2, 3 and this. All are common. In both case, it is there. Okay, then common factors are 2 into 2 into 3, that is equivalent to 12. So that means I can take 12 as a common factor from both the terms. Okay, this is one term, this is one term. So these are in a separate form, that's why I cannot write in a bracket. Okay, now next one, very simple part, first question, 2y, then 22xy. How can I write down 2y? How can I write down 2y? 2y can be written 2 into y, and 22xy can be written 2 into 11 into x into y. What is common here? 2 and 2 and y. Therefore, common factors, how many are common factors? So 2 and y, that is 2y. So we can take 2y as a common factor from both the expression together. Okay, terms together. Okay, now I'm coming to the next. Write down quickly, so it will help you to cover the syllabus also. And side by side, when I give you extra question, so you can do it. Okay, now 3. 14 PQ and 28 Q square. You, before solving, you have to see the instruction. What is given in instruction? Factorize all the common factor. Here the instruction is not factorize, take the common factor. And after that, how to represent in a factorization form, that is the second question. Okay, now 14 PQ can be written 2 into 7. Always you have to break down the numerical factor into prime number. You have to break down the numerical factor into prime, product of prime. 2 is a prime number, 7 also prime number. And P into Q. Now 28, how can I write down? 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 7, 28. And then 28 P square, Q square. Now P square can be written P into P, Q square, Q into Q. So what is common factor? Common factors are, so here 2, 7, 2, 7. I will get numerical factor 2, 7 as a common. Now PQ and PQ, these two are common, PQ. So after multiplying, I am getting what? 14 PQ is the common factor of both the expressions. Okay? How understood? Now next coming, 4, 2x, 3x square, and 4. Three terms are there, no problem. What was the number of terms are there? It should be more than one. Okay, so now 2x can be written, how can I write down 2x? 2x can be written 2 into x. 3x square can be written 3 into x. 4 can be written 2 into 2. Therefore, common factors are, so what is common here? 2 is common, 2 is common. X is common, x is common. So therefore, common factors are 2 into x, that is 2x. Have you understood? Why I am showing this form? Because when you find out the common factorizations, so during factorizations of the term expression, so we take out the common factor only. So how to take common factors? This is given. Okay, first question is how to take common factor. Second question is what? How to factorize? That means during factorization, what do we do? We definitely take the common factor, and that time no need to show this way orally. How much maximum literal factors and numerical factor we can take common from all the terms in a particular expression. Okay, and that time we will do it orally. Now here I am showing how to take common. Okay. Now next is, after this it is 5, 6 ABC, comma, 24 A B square, and then 12 A square B. No problem. You should write down 6 ABC can be written 2 into 3, 6 into A into A into B into C. Now 24 AB square can be written 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 3, 24. Always you have to break down the number into prime, product of prime, into A into B into C. And now, this one is for before one, B into B, B square. Now 12 A square B, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 3, 12 into A into A into B. So then common factors. Common factors are, what will be the common factors? This 2, 3A, 2 and 3, common A, B, A, B, no C here. Now here also, when you take the common, it should be common in all three. Not, it is like that, we have two common in this part and another is not having. 2, 3, one common and B, A, B. A and B, A and B, and A and B, A and B. Okay, so you have to take carefully the common factor. When you take the common, if it's three terms are there, so we have to take whatever the common in three terms. It is not like that we have something here, the C is here, but no C is here. So I cannot take common. Okay. So here some more A, more B are there. I cannot take common. When it is available in all the terms, okay, then you only can take common. So it will be 2 into 3 into A into B. That is 6AB. Common factor is 6AB. Clear? Now next is 6. 6 is sixteen x cube minus 4 x square minus 32 x. Break down the number 16x cube. 16x cube can be written 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 2, 16. And then x cube can be written x into x into x. Now minus 4 x square can be written minus bracket 2 into 2, 4 into x into x. You can take common. And here minus 32x should be 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 2, 16, 16 into 2, 32 into x. Now, when you take common, it should be all, but be careful, there is a negative sign. What will you do in that case? Okay? So, here you see how many, maximum 2 you can take common, 2. Okay? How many maximum x? So, here also 2. Maximum x is mean there are 3x, and there are 2x, and there are only 1x. This one. Leave it. I cannot take minus part is common for all. So, therefore, you have to write down common factors are, common factors are clear. It will be 2 into 2 into x. 1x I have taken common from here into x, that is 4x. 4x is common. This minus sign I am leaving it for x only. So this minus sign you can consider for any one of the number. I am not taking this minus sign common. That's why if I take 2 into 2 into x common, then this minus sign will be left out for particular 1x. Okay. So that's why I am not taking common. What about the available factors are there? 2 2's, and only 1x I can take common from here. Only 1x. Okay. So this is the solution. Now next is you will practice at home, very simple type calculation. So if it is coming, so it will be only 1 mark only, not more than 1 mark. Okay. So now 7, 10 PQ minus 20 QR minus common, sorry, no minus sign, 10 PQ, 20 QR and 30 RP. What can I take common? So you write down 10 PQ can be written 2 into 5, 10 prime numbers into P into Q. 20 QR can be written 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 5, 20, and then Q and then R. 30 RP. So maximum what can I take common? 2 into 3 into 5. It should be prime. 2 threes are. If you are not able to break down orally, you can perform the factorization outside. You will break down the 30 in prime factors, not in composite. So it will be 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 5, 30. So 2, 3, 5, all 3 are prime. Mind it, it should be prime, not composite. Okay. Now into R into P. So therefore, common factors are, what will be common? 2, 2, 2. So you will get 1, 2. 5, 5, 5. You will get 1, 5. So P, no P. Q, Q is there. But there is no. So PQR is not common for all. We have PQ here, but here QR, only Q. And here RP. So I cannot take any little factor common from all three. What to do? Then leave it. So answer is 10 only. So common factor is 10 only. Understood? When it is not available in all, you cannot take common. Okay? You will take those factors. It may be like little factor or it may be numerical factors. So this should be common for all. Mind it. So now, next is 8. 8 is 3 x square y cube, comma, then tan x cube y square, comma, then 6 x square y square z. Very simple, no problem. So 3 x cube, how can I write down 3 x square y cube? Can be written 3, only one factor 3. Then x square means x into x, y cube means y into y into y. 10 x square x cube y square, 10 x cube y square, 2 into 5, 10 into x into x into x into y into y. Then 6 x square y square z, 6 x square y square z equals to 2 into 3 into x into x into y into z. Okay, therefore common factors, how much you can take common from here? Number 3, it is not only these two, but we don't have here. So numerical factor I cannot take common. 5, no 5. 2 in 3 places 2. 3 in 2 places 3. So I cannot take common. So what is, how many x is there? 2x, 3x, 2x. So maximum 2x I can take common. And how many y? 3y, 2y, 2y. So 2y I can take common. Okay. How many z? Only one place is z. So I cannot take common. So x into x, y into y, that equals to x square y square. Understood? So this is, so no numerical factor is common for all the three terms. I cannot take. So 3 was there, but here there is no 3. That's why I cannot take common. I told you categorically, it should be common for all the terms. Okay, so this is about the question number 1. Question number 2, same thing we will do, but you have to do it orally. How much maximum factor we can take common from 2, 3 terms present in that expression. Okay, so that we will do. Question number 2 is nothing, only the direct solution we have to show, and the factorization means what? Way of representing number into product of prime factors. We have to show in a product form. That is the factorization. So say, what are factors then? It is given in the video also. Factor is a part of number. Who is divides the number exactly? Leaving remainder 0. Okay. Or it is a divisor of that number. Who is can divide the number exactly? So this is prime factor. Factorization, so when you take common, we have to take such a number which can divide the other number exactly. Okay. And when you take common for all two, question number 2, you will come to know gradually. No problem. Okay. Now, first part is 7x minus 42. What is common? Numerical factor is 7. Literal factor is x. But here is no literal factor, only numerical factor. So, can you divide 42 by 7? Yes, I can divide 42 by 7. I can divide 7 by 7. So, 7 is a what? Common factor of both. Okay. So, if I take 7 as a common factor, so if I divide 7, 7 divided by 7 out, only x will left out. Okay. And here, if I divide by 7, I will get 6. So, now this is expression and this is factorization. Because same expression I have written in a product of two factors. 7 is one factor and x minus 6 another factor. X minus 6 is a factor of this. Okay? And 7 is also a factor of this. So it is a product of two factors. Clear? So now 2 6p minus 12q. Same, I can divide 6, maximum common. Don't think sir 6 is not a prime number, why you are taking 6? We can take 2, 3 also, this way also. But now what I say, I will solve it orally. Maximum number, how much you can take in from these two terms. So 6 divided by 6, 12 also divided by 6, exactly, leaving the remainder 0. Okay, so now if I take 6 as a common factor, so what is left out here? P. And if I take 6 as a common factor, 6 2s are 12 and it is Q. So now no little factor I can take common. So this is your expression 6P minus 2Q, 12Q, and 6 into P minus 2Q is a factorization. The factorizations of this is equal to this. Okay, it is expression, it is factorization, because it is a product of two factors. One is a 6, another is a P minus 2Q. P minus 2Q, one factor of this, and 6 is also. That means we can divide this expression by 6, we can divide the expression by P minus 2Q. How can I divide it by P minus 2Q? It will come later on. Because when division of polynomial will discuss, you will come to know that 6P minus 12Q can also be divided by P minus 2Q. How? It will come to know later on. Okay? Now, next is, so what we are taking, which method we are following now? We are following factorization by taking common. First part, factorization by taking common. From my video, small video, introductory video, what have I shown? So, from that part only I am talking about. We are performing factorization by taking common factors together. How to take common factors? That was in question number 1. Okay. And now, I am coming to third part. That is 7a square plus 14a. Now, how much you can take common from both this number? Little number, numerical factor is 7, 14. 7 can be divided by 7 and 14 also can be divided by 7. Okay. So then 7. Now, a square means a into a and here only a. So what is the maximum little factor you can take common? A only. So here there are 2a and it's only 1a. A. If I divide by 7, so 7 will be out. If I divide by a, so 1a will reduce and another a will be left out. So if I divide by 7, it will be 2. And if you divide by a divided by a is cancelled. A divided by a. A divided by a. 1. So 1 already, 1 into 2 is 2 only. So no need to write. So we are taking common means we are dividing. So this one is the factorization. It is expression, this is factorization. The product of two factors. One is the 7a, another is the a plus 2. That means this expression, we can divide it by 7a. Okay, this expression we can divide by a plus 2. Okay, so this is what? This is factorization. Only two lines. Number 4, minus 16j plus 20j square. So what is maximum number and little number? This is number and this is little number. Number, little number. What is the maximum number you can take common from the both? 16 can be divided by 4, maximum. 2 also divisible. But I say maximum number you can take common. What is the biggest number that divides 16 and 20? So 16 is divided by 4, biggest number, and 20 also divided by 4. 20 can be divided by 5 also, but 16 is not divisible by 5. We have to take such a number that is also maximum number which can divide both the number. So if I divide, if I take 4 as a common factor, it will be divisible both. Now we have z and z square. So 1 z I can take common. So when you divide this one by 4 z, so 4 4s are 16, j, one jet was there, you have to take common out, but this negative sign will be here only, not here. Okay. Because after multiplication, it will, again it will come back, minus 16 jet. Okay, 4 jet minus 4 is equal to minus 16 jet. Plus, if I divide by this 4 jet, how much I will get? 4, 5s are 20. And jet, you have taken one common, one jet will be left out. So, this is expression, this is factorization. Now, if someone is taking minus sign common here, yeah, so obviously then this sign will be changed. Plus will be minus. You can write down this minus sign, minus 4 jet if you take common. So, it will be positive 4. And if it was negative, convert into positive, that's why this one positive will convert into negative. When you take common. So, this will come to know later on. Okay. So, fifth part is what? 20 t square m plus 30 a l m. Now, tell me, what is the biggest number you can take common? Which biggest number can divide both the number? So, when I say biggest number, it may be prime, it may be composite, that does not matter. Earlier, when you factorize, it is always prime number. Okay. Now, how much maximum number you can take common from both? 20 and 30. Which is the number which can divide 20 and 30 exactly? 10. We can divide 20 by 10. We can divide 30 by 10. I can divide 30 by 15 also. But we cannot. So, greatest number which can divide both. Okay. So, 10. 10 numerical factor is common. And now, after that, we have Tm. It is L square M. It is L square M. L square M. Now, we have L square, I have A. So, maximum common will be L only. We have M and M both sides. I can take M as common. Now, if I divide it by now, tell LM, so 10, if you divide it by 10, it will be 2 only. L square M, I have taken one common, one L is left out. M, I have taken common out. Then plus, divide by 10 is equal to 30. LM, you have taken common, LM out, only A is left out. So, this is expression, this is factorization. Any doubt? Okay. So, you practice at home with some extra question, you will come to know. Okay. Now, next one is what? 5, then 6. This one is 6, 5 x square y minus 15 x y square. What is common here? Maximum number is 5. 5 can divide by 5 is divisible by 5 and 15 also divisible by 5. Now x square y and xy. So only xy is the we can take 2x here, only 1x. So 1x. Y is 1, y is 2. The maximum common is 1. So if I divide by 5, 5 will be out, 1x will be out, the 1x is left out and y is out. Okay. Now here, if I divide by 5, it will be 3. 5 threes are 15, x is out, 1 y is out, and 1 y will be left out. Okay, so please follow my instruction. This is the new chapter we have started after half yearly exam. So, definitely it will cover your periodic test 2. Okay, so when you have, definitely it will be a syllabus. Okay, now 6 is over, 7. 7, 10 x square minus 15 b square plus 20 c square. So, 3 terms are there, no problem. As many as terms are there, no problem. Only if you consider what is the maximum literal factor I can take common from all 3, all 4, all 5, whatever the numbers are there. So, I can divide it by 5, I can divide it by 5, I can divide it by 5. So, 5 is the maximum number which can we divide both. But we have a square, we have b square, we have c square. So none of the little factor common in all. So I cannot take common. So if I divide by 5, it will be 2a square minus, if we divide by 5, with 3b square plus, if we divide by 5, 4c square. Okay? Nothing can be done further. Okay. Now, next is minus 8. 8 question. Minus 4a square plus 4ab minus 4ca. What is the maximum number I can take common here? Obviously 4. A square, AB, CA. It is A square. What is the common in all? A, I can take 1. A, if I take common. What is left out here? So 4 is out, 1 is out. So minus A is left out. This minus sign will be for that factor which is left out. Minus A. And then plus, if I divide by 4, 4A out, only B is left out. Minus, if I divide by 4A, 4A is out, C is left out. Okay? So, this is the final answer. Clear? Now, we will do two questions only because next day I will be solving regrouping. X square yz plus x y square z plus x y z square. Three terms. What is the maximum number you can take common from here? No literal factors. There is no numerical factor. XYZ. I cannot take more than XYZ. XYZ will be available for all three. So if I take common XYZ from here, Y out, Z out, on X out, so 1X is left out. Plus, if I divide by this, so X out, Z out, 1Y is out, so only 1 is left out. So next, XYZ out, so Z is left out. Okay, so this is factorizations of this expression. Now 10. Clear? A x square y plus b x y square plus c x y z. So what is the literal factor is common in all? A x y, b x y, c x y. So, which factor is common in all? Can you tell me? So, you see, a x y, b x y, c x y. Only you can say x y, x y, x y, x y. So, x y is common in all. So, if I take x y as a common factor, so what is left out? A is left out or 1x is left out. AX is left out here. If I take XY is common, so BY is left out. X out, 1Y is out. Plus, if I take XY is common, this one is common, so only CJ. CJ is left out. Okay? So, this is all about question number 2. So, next day, I will solve factorization only, but how to factorize by following regrouping method. We have to regroup the expressions given and after that we will take common from two of the terms or three terms together. Okay, so that will be next day. Till then, bye bye students.